Someone show him the actual address to send it to. So that he has it. You can write down this address, Denny. I forget last time I had to call him, but what if someone's in it? Like, if you send the money to the wrong PayPal, you should be able to call PayPal and say, hey, I sent this PayPal to the wrong person. It's a completely wrong address. So dispute it. We do it after we open. I'm just going to pick the box. There's 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Here's the box we're using. The box we're using is box 2. 3 is out. 1 is out. That leaves 2. So, Denny, you know how this works. You're going to get 2 cards. We're going to random the list. Yeah, call him tomorrow morning, Denny. And say, hey, I sent a payment last night and it got sent to the wrong place. You don't have to tell them where you want to send it to. Just say, I sent it to the wrong place. Come on, please be a dope booklet in here after all this work. I wonder what's in here. I wonder what's in those Spectre boxes. Yeah, this is the box of my tuna. The other box, I got a sick baseball mixer for Friday night. I forgot, I meant to put Bowman in it. But I started building it and I put it on the website. It was too late. All right, somebody at home wants to catalog the hits. Carter, is that you? Is that you? Your first definitive card is Dennis Eckersley to 25. Expensive ass stuff. Dennis Eckersley. Yes. Michael Kopech to 50. Oh, man. I'll save this frame because I don't know who it is. We'll go this way. I-Rod and Yachty to 35. I mean, the cards are nice. I like the etching they do there. Whatever that, not etching, but. Forget what they call that. Justin Upton to 15 for the Angels. Another I-Rod to 50. God, come on, Definitive. Here's a game-used piece of Andrew McCutchen's jersey. Wow. Oh, boy. That's a sick piece of memorabilia, though. It's Whit Merrifield, but... game-used. Super shiny. My goodness. Big Poppy to 10. Purple Poppy. Eight cards. What'd you call? All right, here's the draft order. The other two boxes are used. One's going to be in the... I'll put up another... maybe I'll try a serial number. Here's the draft order. One more to go. Boom. Neil. The Tickler. Denny and Denny. Neil, Neil. Ed and Tyson. Poor dude goes to the bottom. Oy vey. There's your code. Congrats, Keneal. Number one overall pick. Yeah, I'm logging them real quick. Wait, to 20. Ivan to 50. Ivan and Yachty, 14 of 15, Justin Upton. Irod to 50. McCutcheon to 35. 20, Whit Merrifield. Big Poppy to 10. Dennis to 25. And Kopech. The numbers in serial were 3s, 5s, 5, 4, 7, 2, 1, and 1. So there definitely would have been skunks if that were serial number. But if you had the 1, you would have got a Michael Kopech and Dennis Eckersley. Hey, at least you don't have $300 or $280 sitting in the wrong PayPal. Denny Hamlin, you're up, Denny Hamlin. Maybe I'll just do a personal box myself of this other definitive. We got a McCutcheon. We got a Whit Merrifield to 20. David is off. Well, we're going to do that Spectre Beast night. I know how much you love basketball. We're going to get a one-of-one Luka Doncic so me and you can get flown to the Fat Cat for dinner. I think I'm going to utilize my cousin's offer. He works for Southwest, and I could do a buddy pass day. I was going to take a flight out to somewhere and get In-N-Out Burger for lunch and come back because it's free to fly. But maybe I'll take a free flight to Quincy for dinner at the Fat Cat and fly home. Denny Hamlin, you get 2 picks in a row. You get 2 picks, Denny. So you're taking Eckersley. And what else do you want? Home slices. Denny, can you email me at topshelfbreaks@gmail.com so we can figure out this PayPal thing in the morning? $21 of $25. Beautiful, perfect auto. That's the thing. These guys take their time on definitive. It's because the Topps reps are probably like, hey, this is our high-end product. It's a beautiful card. Please take your time signing it. I wonder how far the queue is from Boston City, downtown. And I wonder if Neil has a Boston accent, hardcore, you know, like a Boston cop. Like a Boston detective. I don't know why I think of detectives and cops when I think of Boston. Saying hello to you for free? What are you talking about? I could hop on a plane tomorrow morning on Southwest, fly into Boston, swing by, meet you for like lunch, hang out, have some drinks, head back to the airport and be home for dinner. The Rodriguez is Ivan. Well, did you not book Chicago yet? You're bringing the kids, right? You're coming, you're full on Chicago touring. Minutes from Logan. That's about how I am with O'Hare. So basically you're in a suburb of from the airport. Beast Nye, did you see the swimmer dude? USA swimmer dude. Michael Phelps, 16x20. You're getting some stuff working. Okay. So I should just go use it for In-N-Out Burger? No, I'll show it to you in a second. Yeah, there's another one Friday. The Upton Auto is to 15. Are we still breaking or yawning? We're freaking breaking, dude. I'm still waiting to see what... Neil, you got two other picks. Did I miss your picks? Oh, snap. Kopech, Eckersley is off. Whit Merrifield, McCutcheon, and Upton. Whit Merrifield to 20. Andrew McCutcheon to 35. Justin Upton to 15 in this Kopech. All I can say, guys, is based on doing this for 5 years, in a high-end product like that, there's probably supreme monsters hiding in those other two boxes. But it just has to be based on that box. Like, if we would have opened this and it would have had a sick booklet monster and some other good guys in it, I would say, well... it's either a hot case or the other boxes are doo-doo. That reminds me, I got to send some money to my parents, too. Crap, and I cleaned out all my PayPal tonight. Shit. Favorite places in Elgin to eat? Zero. There's a cafe right next door. They got a good Italian, Rob. It's right next door. Little cafe place. It's not my favorite in the world, but it's right next door. Who is this Emmett you speak of? Spectra, what are we doing? What do we do tonight? $27. $27 triple teamer. Yeah, Denny took Eckersley and Irod. Sorry, I gotta update the sheet. My fault. My fault. Yeah, I'm sorry. I bamboozled Tyson to get in this. Whit Merrifield at 20. It's a nice game-worn jersey, at least. Justin Upton is semi-dope. All red Angels. Andrew McCutchen is playing pretty dope, I think. Number to 35. And then the last auto, besides Upton, is Kopech. Yeah. Kopech and Witt. Ed. McCutchen or Upton? Yeah, that was pretty crappy, dudes. I'm sorry. Whose idea was this? Oh, we all know that that box we opened could have very well easily been a monster of all monsters. A monster among men, if I will. Ed, I got a question for you. This is definitely a good question. If you had your choice, but you can only do one. You can only do one. Do you come in for the day for AEW All Out with some dope ass seats? Or do you come for the National? Which would you do? Which would you do? National? Or would you come for All Out at the Sears Center to watch it? And remember, I went to All In, and it was the most greatest wrestling event I've ever been to. And I've been to a lot. Are you guys tapped out? Or, Neil, do you want a personal box? I can text you a personal price. I don't know what your budgets are looking like, but if you want a personal box of that, I could certainly give you a off-the-record price for it. So, Danny, don't forget to send me an email at topshelfbreaks@gmail.com so we can communicate about that PayPal thing. I called them the last time it happened and told them that the customer sent it to the wrong email address. And then they just canceled it, sent it back. Guess I could do that. Because I don't know if the seller, if the person who sent it calls and says, oh, I don't want to send it, how can they take it back out of my account? He sent it friends and family. I'll call him in the morning. You'd rather go to Nationals? Oh, man. You did? Wow, Danny, you really did do that? Dude. That helps me a lot. The reason is because I got to send my parents some money. They're traveling back to Harrisburg on Friday. And my dad asked if I could help out with some expenses. And I said, sure. But I forgot that I transfer all my money out of PayPal at the end of each night, which I already did for the night. So if you sent that over to that other one, I can send that to them. So did you guys see that? I look at it. Denny sent that money. Dennett Hansel. Is he a good fit here or what? So he sent it to the Top Shelf Breaks PayPal, which we're going to figure out in the morning. He can either dispute it or I can call him and tell him this isn't my money. It was sent to me inadvertently. Send it back to the original person. And I'll send it back to him. But for him to send that over, that means a lot, Dennett. I appreciate that. So we'll get it back for you. It'll come back one way or the other, either from me by calling and saying that the introvert, I received this money and I don't know what the hell it is. Yeah. Yeah, just call and dispute it and tell him you sent it to the wrong place. And I won't dispute it. I'll just... Yeah, it is. That's a good sign. That's a good sign. I mean, I can still send PayPal to my parents. It just comes out of my bank account. But I prefer, that's why I use that Big Idea account, because that's what I use for stuff like that. It doesn't go to the business account. It goes in the other account. And all the orders come through Breaking All-Star. Oh, so maybe there's something in your account. Maybe there's something on my end I can look. I just remember the last time I was panicking because it was for a case. It was over $2,000, I remember. And I called him in the morning and said that the customer sent it to the wrong PayPal. That's not the PayPal I wanted them to send it to. And they were like, okay, calm down. I made up something like, yeah, well, there's a lot of trucks waiting and they won't leave until they get the payment. I got to get it out of there and back. And they're like, oh, okay, relax, dude. We'll send it back. Ed, flights are not getting any cheaper. Flip it and reverse it. So I'm going to, for tomorrow, Spectra, unless anybody wants to do a personal box of finest. What do we got on the website? One box of finest? I mean, one triple teamer or something? I can't wait to go off the air so I can listen to Hustle and Curse. Or Hustle and Cuss is the name of the song by The Dead Weather. Spotify that one. The Dead Weather, Hustle and Cuss. I'll see if anybody wants to open stuff, but for now, it's back to Pearl Jam Radio on TSB, yo. triple teamer Tyson. I mean, Breece Knight, I've used that one before. Triple teamer. I hardly knew her. What the heck? So, Bowman baseball tomorrow night. Maybe some more score. Actually, was there a score tonight to do? Another score? Did I miss that? Let's see. Sanderson Cup. A couple donations came in today. Appreciate that. Yeah, there is a score. Nahal Dennett. I'm going to do that now. Don't call me Grammy. Not fit to be. The picture kept will remind me. Don't call me daughter. Not fit to. The picture kept will remind me. Denny Hamlin, you're in this one, dude. I remember playing this in radio. It was like the song that never ended. It just like would taper out. Hey, Beast Knight, good seeing you here tonight, my friend. Yes, good seeing us. Check out the TriStar. There's a pretty dope Michael Phelps. Yeah, there's like 20 seconds more of this. But then there's this. I cannot get this song out of my head. It was in my head all day driving around. It would pop into my head. I just like the drums in it, the song. And the bass line there, the little groove. And the cymbals. Score number two is coming up here in my break room.
Cause I still feel the same.
Oh, yeah. Oh, Hustle and Cuss, man. I'm gonna test that on another channel and play it and see what happens if YouTube blocks the video. I just don't understand how some of these other breakers play music in the background. They got ESPN going and they don't get their videos blocked, obviously, or else, you know, their whole feed would be blocked. There's Adam. Adam is new. Adam, it's late.